Darlene McLendon, I'm President and CEO of Perry Area Chamber of Commerce, and welcome to the first official Perry Proud episode. We're so excited about having this as a monthly show to bring to our viewers points of interest in and around Perry. Obviously, points of interest with our chamber. It is a Perry Area Chamber project and platform that we have ventured into. So we welcome our viewers to submit ideas. Call us up at the chamber, let us know what interests you and what we can cover on the show and who we can bring on as guests. Again, it's our first official, which gives me a lot of pleasure to introduce to the community someone that I know is well known by many in our community, Mr. David Campbell. He is the administrator at the Perry Hospital here, and he is also our current board chair with the Perry Area Chamber of Commerce. David, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you, Darlene. It's great to be here.
Well, I don't know how excited you are about the Perry Proud Show. I think I recently have kind of looped you into my thoughts and plans for it and the staff, but I hope you share the excitement that we think we can get this as a steady monthly episode for our community.
I do. I think it's another great opportunity for the Chamber to be able to for another venue to be able to share what's going on with the chamber, what's going on in the community, and it's all good.
Thank you. We're excited. David, I know you've been involved with Perry Chamber for many years. You've served in our Governmental Affairs Committee. You are active on our Military Affairs Committee. I want to personally thank you for your leadership as our 2016 board chair. A lot of people don't know what type of commitment that is, but it is a huge time commitment, and obviously it adds to your responsibilities. But how's the experience been for you so far?
It's been a great experience thus far. Obviously, this is a people business, and it's been great meeting all the people that are integrally involved in the chamber, from the staff to the various volunteers, the people that are on the board, the executive committee, everybody. It's just been a really good experience, very positive experience, and I encourage everybody to take part in any measure that they're able to. It certainly has added to my calendar, as you referenced, and that's been the biggest challenge for me with so much involvement going on elsewhere, but you can always make it up at the end of the day, so it's been all good.
Well, you bring up a very good point. Our volunteers, it is a dedicated group of volunteers, which includes our board and all the committees. And what they do for our chamber allows us to be active in the community, allows us to grow the business community, and which goes hand in hand with our mission here at the chamber. You mentioned the need, meeting the needs of our members and our community, that partnership. In 2015, the chamber adopted its first ever motto, Grow Business, Grow Community. What are your thoughts on that? Can you tell us more about that?
Well, the Chamber's made up of primarily businesses that want to support business. They want to support growth of business in the community, and the Chamber offers a vehicle for people to do that, not to kind of get outside of their own comfort zone, maybe to get outside of their area of influence and work together to expand the business climate, improve the business climate in this community. We do so not only with the business community, but with the civic community. We're closely with government, volunteer organizations, and others, and that enables everybody to prosper. It's not an independent function of the business community or the civic community, but an interdependent one where everybody works together for the common good of the community.
Very, very well said on that, and that's the thing that the new motto is definitely trying to make sure that the community does understand. We know that we serve our members, but that interrelationship between the two. Along those lines, tell us some of the things that the Perry Chamber does for the community as a whole.
Well, this past year we've been obviously host of the Dogwood Festival, annual event, which is just a great event in downtown Perry. We then move on out from downtown Perry in the evening out to the fairgrounds and hosted a balloon globe out there. But the downtown festival was a huge success this year. The Ultimate Air Dogs are very entertaining. That again seems to just draw a lot of cheers and a lot of enthusiasm from the crowd. The vendors at the downtown Arts and Crafts Festival, there's a lot of food, a lot of activity going on. The vendors just were overflowing in their praise of the job that the staff here at the Chamber did this year, and they were they're anxious to come back. You know, we've lost some events in years past outside of the Chamber, nothing to do with the Chamber, but I think this has filled the gap for the community and being able to offer that type of an event. It's been a whole lot of fun for everybody. It's a great turnout, big crowds, and a two-day festival that I think everybody really enjoys.
It is an opportunity that people wait for every year.
It is, and then of course we have the July 4th parade, which it was a little wet this year, but I think, again, everybody had fun. I know the people on my float, even though they got soaked, were enthusiastic about the opportunity and had fun and certainly created some memories out of that. And then, of course, the fireworks after that, which fortunately were not affected by the rain, and it was a big time. People just enjoy getting out with their families at the fairground and having good family time and having a lot of room for the kids to run around unfettered. And I don't think you even have to have the great music necessarily that we had, although everybody enjoyed that. Just getting the kids out there with a ball or a frisbee or something, they had a huge time.
I think that is one of the best parts of both of those major events that we do in the community, with the balloons at Dogwood, with the fireworks at the 4th. It's safe. You feel wonderful about letting your kids just roam and play. And personally, my kids are up and grown, so to watch those young families, that's our future.
Oh, absolutely. I think it builds community. It builds unity. It's just a great event for the community. We need more of that, obviously.
Absolutely, absolutely. You're correct. I tell you, I cannot take credit for taking that good care of those vendors. Bonnie in our office has built a relationship with those, and our Dogwood Festival has become a don't miss a bit for them as well as for the community. And obviously with the Ultimate Air Dogs that you mentioned jumping.
I noticed that people are even bringing their dogs that don't jump, just kind of having little chihuahuas and dachshunds as spectators, and they seem to enjoy the event as well.
Every once in a while you'll get one of those little ones that runs right to the end, and then they turn around or they put on those brakes and they look for mama in the crowd. It is a lot of fun. Unfortunately, this year we did lose the balloon tethering portion of our event out at the fairgrounds. And, you know, when you work in chamber world and you work in the event planning world, you're especially outdoor events, I'm kind of used to hoping it doesn't rain. I'll be honest, I wasn't asking too much. Don't let the wind be too high either. I think I learned a little bit of a lesson this year.
So I've been a sailor all my life, and usually too little wind has been my nemesis, but this year it's too much. So unfortunately, they didn't get to go up, actually went up Sunday, I believe, but it still is beautiful watching those things filled with fuel. And it's just against the night sky, it really is something to behold.
The glow is really an awesome event. If by chance you have not been able to make it out on the fairgrounds, I tell you, you need to put that on your calendar, all of our viewers, and join us next year at the Balloon Glow. It is always the first full weekend of April, and we'll be talking more about that later on in the show. But go ahead and put that on your calendar. The Balloon Glow is just awesome. I mentioned earlier, David, that you're part of our Military Affairs Committee. And I think that our viewers, a lot of them might not even know what that means. I personally did not come out of a military community, military background or anything, and so I have learned a lot. But tell us something about that committee and why you are dedicated to that.
Well, I've always enjoyed, been a member of the Military Affairs Committee for many years now. I've served as a volunteer commander on the base, and it really does, I think, speak to this community, what they do for the men and women in the armed services. The Military Affairs Committee is behind some of those efforts, but as the community as a whole is very, very involved, as I think everybody knows, with the base and supporting the base. I don't think you can overestimate the impact that the base has on this community and on this region, and certainly we want to do everything we can to support those people that are supporting us by serving in the military. It's been a good organization too, not just in this community, but regionally. We were members of the Military Affairs Committee through this chamber, and that goes a long way towards supporting the Bobbins Air Force Base.
You know, that is something that all of Middle Georgia does and should take seriously, is the support of our base and those that serve us and protect our freedoms. We are very grateful for that. There's a little something coming up on that installation north of us in the first part of October.
October 1st and 2nd, Thunder Over Georgia will be a huge event. It's been a while since we've had an air show out there, and you'll have people from all over the region, all over the state, and it should be a good time. They'll have obviously a lot of vintage aircraft and multiple events, people jumping out of perfectly good airplanes, and it'll be just a good time. I think everybody should try to put it on their calendar now to make sure that they're available to show up.
You know, there may have been some younger years that I might have done that, but I might be past that, jumping out of a perfectly good airplane.
Certainly,
in my stage, I tell you. That will be an exciting time for our community. Certainly hope that the community shows up, and what that says to the men and women that serve our country is tremendous. And as a matter of fact, I know I've been in meetings, as you have as well, with the Middle Georgia Military Affairs Committee, which is kind of our umbrella, MAC as we call it, and they were saying how those up at the in Washington pay attention to how a local community supports the events such as air shows. So while you're getting to have a good time, you're also showing support of how important that installation is to us. So I look forward to that. I'm sure that everyone else will show up in a big way.
Sure they will. Thank you, Darlene. I know that I'm going to be there, and I'm going to try to bring people from friends from out of town to make sure they're aware of it, so that in case the word doesn't get out, they'll at least hear from me and that will be available.
Absolutely. Well, David, thank you again for joining me today, helping to inform our viewers of what's going on in the chamber and the community as a whole. I know we mentioned that you play a professional role in Perry with the House and Health Care, specifically at the Perry Hospital. And I'd like to thank you for your leadership and that of House and Health Care. They are supportive of you leading our organization. I know that House and Health Care really increased their visual support even of our community through the Independence Parade this year, and we appreciate that. We do. The community knows that you're there. Your line of business is one that people don't know how much they appreciate it and need it until they need it. So knowing that y'all were out in a visual component with that parade, I'm sorry it got a little bit rained on, but that meant a tremendous amount to the chamber, and I'm glad that the community also was reminded about all that y'all do for the community.
Well, thank you, Darlene. It's always an honor to be able to do anything to support the men and women in our armed services, and certainly anything that we can do to support Robins Air Force Base, as I mentioned earlier, is certainly time and money well spent. And I do appreciate our board's support, both for me serving in this capacity as well as the financial support they're given to the chamber, and it's been a real pleasure.
I'm so pleased to have joined me today with our Perry Proud episode, Mayor of Perry, Mr. Jimmy Fairclough. Jimmy, thank you so much for taking time out of your, I know, very busy schedule to join me.
Darlene, it's certainly a pleasure for me to take time out of any schedule that I have in order to help focus on the chamber and the great things that it does, not only for the city of Perry, but for our region.
Well, thank you. At the Perry Chamber, we are very pleased. I know you've heard of a lot of our different mottos that we've tried to come up with. In 2015, we created the Perry Proud Movement, which I think the community took hold of and joined. But the other part of our changes in 2015, we created our first motto, and that was Grow Business, Grow Community. And I hope that does speak to our role that we want to do both.
Absolutely. You know that we are very proud of Perry, to say the least, but we're also very cognizant of the businesses that make up that system of network as well as people. There are multiple people and sources of tax revenue. There's multiple people and sources of fee revenue. We don't live in a vacuum. We do know that it takes businesses and small businesses specifically in order to make systems work, in order to make communities work, in order to make cities work, as well as small businesses like the chamber. We are very pleased that you do take such an active role in supporting and representing the business community, like I said, not only for the city, but in the region and even the state. Their voice is as critical today as it ever will be in the history of not only our city, but this region and state, and even the nation.
You're right.
They need to know what's going on, but by the same token, the people who make decisions on their behalf also need to hear from them on how those decisions are affecting them on a day-to-day basis.
You bring up a great point there, Jimmy, and not only just the support that the chamber gets in our community events, Dogwood, the parade, absolutely could not do it without the city and y'all support. Thank you so very much. But the partnership that is there at all times, I know that I get to see city council in action. I try to make it to a work session. I also try to make sure I'm balancing that with actual city council sessions. I really enjoy the work sessions because I get to hear the thinking and the talking behind the issues and the concerns. But thank you for y'all's efforts and how you have those opportunities.
Well, you're most welcome. As you may know, we're required by law to meet twice a month. That's the first and third Tuesdays of each month by legislative act. What we have done since I've been mayor and this council has been in session is created a work session that you've already alluded to. We meet the first and third Mondays of each month. So Monday and Tuesdays, we meet. What's interesting about that is that the work sessions on Monday are the free-for-all is not a good word, but that's essentially what happens. Well, that's where anything and everything can come up, no matter how trivial, no matter how important. And that's where we hash things out as a council. That's where we have all of our department heads present. That's where we receive input from the public. That's where we receive people or businesses that have ideas or presentations. That's the forum in which that occurs. In addition to that, we don't take votes in work sessions unless there's something absolutely critical of a timing nature that has to happen. We legally can anytime we have a quorum. And we have quorums present, obviously. Another important point is that all of our meetings, every single one of them, are open to the public.
Absolutely.
In these work sessions, council hashes things out. Like I've said, we have in-depth discussion. If we need additional information, we get it. We table items and or pin them until further information. At the point in which council is ready to make a decision, that's when we will refer that to the next available council meeting. So what goes on in a Tuesday evening council meeting doesn't necessarily relate to what happened the night before in a work session. But eventually, what goes on in a work session, if it needs a vote or is important to the well-being of the city and the citizens, will eventually show up in a council meeting. That's also why you may notice, if you just watch the council meetings, it appears that all of the votes are unanimous, which most of them are, and there's no discussion. Well, the reason is all the discussion happened in a work session or multiple work sessions, as the case normally is, in order to flesh out a specific topic or function that we're looking at.
Well, and I would encourage our viewers to take that opportunity to attend those meetings, because yes, that is your opportunity to listen and your opportunity to be heard.
Absolutely.
And we appreciate that. It has never been more important in our city, our county, our state, and definitely our nation. Well, Mayor, Perry has a lot of good things going for it right now. And among these, we appreciate the city's efforts to place us on the map even bigger and better. Very excited about the new branding initiative.
Yes.
It has turned out. Love it. Tell us what you love about it.
Well, if you go back, the brand, if you will, of Perry has been different, if you will. I don't think this has been an official brand. We have had, as a matter of course, the clock towers, and it's a recognizable symbol of the Georgia National Fairgrounds and Agri Center. wonderful facility. Thousands upon thousands of people take advantage of those facilities on a weekly basis, actually. We're very proud to have it in our community, very proud of the relationship that we have with that organization, and will continue to do so. However, there was a group of people that got together and said, what exactly does Perry stand for? What is it that we want people to think of when they think of Perry, Georgia? And after much consideration and several different subcommittees reviewing it, the decision was made by upon recommendation was to made by council to hire a professional. And we did exactly that. They came in and had numerous interviews with business leaders, with citizens in the community, with various commercial and retail establishments, with the man and woman on the street, if you will. They would even walk into the convenience stores and say, tell me about Perry. And
wow.
You know, in order to get as much input as possible.
Uh-huh.
And that's one of the things that they took back in their consideration. Then they had further meetings with the various committees. And the brand, as we know it now, Perry, where Georgia comes together, was the final result. They even had a logo that we have incorporated into everything, and we're very excited and pleased about it. Now, one of the things that came up was that the Georgia National Fairgrounds and Agri Center is what most people, specifically outside of the city of Perry, associate with the city,
uh-huh.
which means that's one of the big draws, and that's fine. But we wanted to make certain that our identity is separate but connected.
Absolutely.
So that was one of the reasons that we elected to go that route, and why we have an identity, and we're so very proud that is what we think is all inclusive.
Absolutely. With it being the opportunity, like you say, for all of Georgia to
right.
come together. I do want to make sure we hit on one of your newest employees. I think that comes segueing with the branding initiative, and I think it gives a great platform. So tell us, introduce our viewers to your newest employee by name and position.
We are very proud to have a young lady by the name of Ellen Farr. She has joined the ranks of the city of Perry as a part-time employee, but her specific instructions are to be our media specialist. She is filling a role that we have known for quite some time now that has been vacant. She is an expert in all things media related, such as the internet, Facebook, Pinterest, Twitter, and I'm going to leave a lot of them out. From that standpoint, but she is already hit the ground running. She is her sole job is to make certain that the message that the city has gets out in all forms of communication, not just print, not just television, but also what I consider, at my age and station,
uh-huh.
the more modern ways of communicating. My son is a senior in college. He doesn't get his news from the newspaper, nor does he get it from watching a TV show. He gets it from the internet. He gets it from his smartphone. He gets it from various sources on that smartphone. And we want to make absolutely certain that what we have to say is represented in each of those mediums. And that's exactly what she's hired to do. And we're very pleased to have her on board and looking for great things.
Awesome, awesome. Well, I've had the pleasure to meet Ellen, and I hope that our viewers will take the moment to call them City Hall, maybe swing by and say hello to her.
Absolutely.
Because I know that she wants to know about her community that she has joined. Bonnie, thank you so much for joining. I don't know that you need an introduction in this community. You've been around the community, and you've been with the chamber for longer than any of us. But I do want our viewers to know that when you call to the chamber, there's a lot of times that you're going to hear this lovely voice on the other side of the phone. She is Bonnie Giles, our Events and Communications Director, and I cannot thank you enough for what you do for this organization and this community as a whole. So
I really appreciate that.
Thank you. I know one of the biggest components of your job, especially at different times in the year, is our events, and those are huge. But in particular on the communication, you've done some really great, new, exciting things for the chamber, both sides, business and community. Tell us real quick about the new website. I love it. I love it, it's so pretty.
We just opened up a new website, it's perrygachamber.com, and we're just really excited, it looks really good, it's really easy to navigate, and we've got a special tab on there, it's called the Chamber Channel.
Love that.
We're videotaping a lot of member testimonies, so we have gone out and talked to different members about why they want to be a chamber member, and we've got member testimonies on there, and then we also have event highlights on there, so it's really interactive, fun part of the website.
Awesome, awesome, and it is, and I love the fact that it goes across platforms. You've done such a great job, and if I pull it up on my phone, it goes to the right sizing for that.
It does. It's interactive with what device you're using, so it resizes, which makes it so much easier to read and find what you're looking for.
It comes like an app.
Yes,
that
it
is
does.
Fantastic. On the community side, you know, we are member-supported, member-driven, yes. Our motto, grow business, grow community. It's a circle, we know that. On the community side, you've created another platform that I'm excited about. Can you tell us about that?
Yes, we're really excited that we have the Perry Proud Facebook page. It's a platform to show where people can put what they're Perry Proud about, and they can send in their information. We just love Perry, and we're looking forward to promoting it more and more.
That's awesome. That is awesome. Good, positive things that
yes.
we can talk about.
Yes.
Stay on the positive. Well, the Chamber's busy. We're a busy organization. We've got a lot that we've done so far this year. We've got a lot coming up. I know the next major event, what is that for us?
The next event that we're doing is Member Market. September 29th is going to be at the Perry Arts Center. And it's just a place for our members to showcase their business to the general public.
That is fantastic. Always a well-attended event. We hope that you can join us. I know one that I'm very excited about. We expanded it last year. Taste of Southern, Thursday, December 1st, starts at 6 o'clock at Miller Murphy Howard Building at the Georgia National Fairgrounds. Looking to expand restaurants. Matter of fact, viewers, if you've got that boutique restaurant within an hour and a half, 2 hour drive of Perry, please reach out to the Chamber and let us know about it so we can reach out to them and you know, get them into Taste of Southern.
Yes.
And before we have our Taste of Southern, we do have a couple other important events. On October 13th, we invite the community and members alike to join us for our industry tour. We are touring Clean Control up in Warner Robins. Steve Davidson is a fantastic community partner and businessman in our community. And also in November.
In November, we're also having the State of the Community Luncheon where you get to come out and hear your leaders speak and let us know what's going on in our community.
And that's November 2nd.
November 2nd.
Board of Education Annex in Perry. Well, Bonnie, we have got lots and lots of reasons to be Perry proud here. We hope that our viewers will come to the Chamber and get you a sticker. Put it on your car, put it on your business. They're free. Just come visit us here at the Chamber. We do want to thank ComSouth, Channel 100. They are a sponsor of this episode. And also we want to thank Cherokee Pines Fitness and Golf. They also sponsored this episode with this wonderful facility. Perry, we're proud. We're proud of you. And we hope that you join us in our mission to make sure that we all know to be Perry proud.